Hey guys, it's me, Kimberly Clark. I normally don't appreciate sensationalist video titles like "You'll never believe what happens next" and stuff like that, or like this one, "My last Sephora haul ever." But I have been feeling some feelings, as a lot of you may have been feeling after the recent Sephora Epic Rewards debacle, and I'm going to share them with you. Welcome to my final Sephora haul ever. Okay, first off, let me say, is this really my final Sephora haul ever? I don't know. What I do know is that Sephora fucked up. If you don't know what happened, Sephora has this kind of loyalty program, Beauty Insider. There are different levels depending on how much money you spend in a calendar year. I happen to be VIB Rouge, which is kind of their top tier of people that blow their money on makeup and stuff. Every time you spend a dollar at Sephora, you get one Beauty Insider reward point. As a Beauty Insider, you have the opportunity to redeem the points that you collect, your loyalty points, for different rewards throughout the year. Often there are 100-point rewards, which are kind of a little sample, or 250-point rewards, which are a little nicer, 500-point rewards, which are even nicer, and then once or twice a year, they do this thing called Epic or Extraordinary Rewards, where you can redeem 1,000, 2,000, 5,000, 10,000 points for really amazing kind of stuff. They did this earlier this year in May, and it was a huge debacle, PR failure situation because they released the rewards in the middle of the night, didn't tell anyone, so all these people that had been saving their points forever didn't really get an opportunity to spend them, and by the time they all kind of woke up and logged on to try to get their rewards, they were all sold out. So Sephora, you know, kind of trying to save face from this, decided to do another rewards program in August. This time they were like, we're gonna tell you when they're being released, we're gonna be a little more clear, we're gonna tell you what all the rewards are so you can look at them and decide what you want, so when it comes time to pick your reward, you can do it really quickly and get what you want and get in, get out. Awesome, it'll be great. And then preceding that Epic Rewards release day, they had a promotion where if you bought anything at Sephora, if you were a Beauty Insider, you would get 2x the points. If you were a VIB, which is the next level up, you would get 3x the points, and if you were a VIB Rouge, you would get 4x the points for every dollar you spent. So that was a pretty huge incentive. People that had like 1,000 points and maybe wanted to get up to the 2,000 point level, you know, you have to spend $250 if you're a VIB Rouge to get 1,000 points. You know, people do that. That's stuff that people did. Or if you had like close to 1,000 points and, you know, you'd spend money. It was basically just like a very successful kind of marketing situation. All of that was fine, really great, and everyone was really excited for this second round of Epic Rewards because the first one this year was so bad. So everyone was like, okay, they know what happened, they're totally gonna fix it, awesome, right? Wrong. What happened this year was they gave a day when it would be released, they kind of gave a loose time frame, business hours, Pacific time, whatever that means, so vague. People were logging on, constantly refreshing, checking all this stuff. You know, and everyone assumed that because of the kind of massive hype and the, you know, ability of Sephora to be able to determine what their demand was, that these rewards were kind of realistic to obtain. And everyone got their hopes up like crazily because there were full descriptions of all the rewards out there. So everyone was like kind of stalking what they wanted. There was like a 10,000 point trip to Paris with Lancome. I wanted this 2,000 point Kat Von D liner vault, which was all her liquid liners and like a signed drawing by her. Awesome, really nice, right? The whole time Sephora was like, we have very limited stock, very limited supply. And so everyone was like, okay, cool, very limited, but there are limited edition things all the time and you can get them as long as you kind of jump on it. Jump on it meaning like within the day or week that they are released. This was not days or weeks. This was seconds. People claimed that they logged on at the exact moment the rewards were released, put things in their cart, tried to check out, reward was gone. All this stuff. And then, you know, some people lucked out and got like multiple rewards somehow. Who knows how, but they just did. I wasn't so lucky. I was actually not at a computer, but I was looking at my phone, the mobile site, kind of refreshing it all throughout the day. I was looking, using the Sephora app, constantly looking at the rewards boutique to see when things were available. And the first inkling that I got of things being available was a notification that the rewards were here, like a little graphic popped up in the little rewards boutique, and when you clicked on it, all the rewards were sold out. So needless to say, people were really pissed about it. And a lot of people in the Beauty Talk message boards, which is Sephora's kind of online forum for discussion, were really upset, and everyone was kind of talking about what they would do. Would they like return all the stuff they'd bought, and would they stop shopping at Sephora? Like what is there to do, you know, with your anger and frustration over this whole situation. And I am a firm believer that consumerism is a powerful tool for change. So, you know what? I was totally on board with those people that wanted to return shit, and guess what? I did. So, this video is going to be a three-part video. First, I'm gonna talk about the things that I returned, and two, a haul where I talk about the stuff that I had bought leading up to the epic rewards with the mega points week stuff and some other stuff that I've gotten at Sephora that I hadn't hauled yet. And then the third part is going to be the kind of silver lining. Like what to do if we can't shop at Sephora. What is there? What is left in life? So here we go. Part one. Sephora has a very generous return policy. You can return anything, whether you've used it, whether you haven't used it, whatever reason you don't like it, you can return it. Get a full refund if you have a receipt, or get store credit if you don't have a receipt. Now, if you are a VIB or a beauty insider and you use your rewards card when you purchased it, you don't need a receipt because they can just look up your stuff online. So I returned my three Kat Von D metallic-y studded kiss lipsticks that I've been bitching about for so long. I returned Wolvesmouth, Poe, and Gothica. Really beautiful looking lipsticks in the tube don't work. They just don't work for me. I also returned a Chaos top coat. It is one of those transformer top coats. It has black and white randomly shaped matte glitter. I ordered one of these online as part of like a sale duo recently, and I had previously purchased one that I didn't even open actually. Since I got a new one on sale, like, I kind of got it as a backup, but I was like, well, I bought one at full price, actually, for $12.50, so I'm gonna return that as part of my protest. And then I also returned a Marc Jacobs Highliner eyeliner. Now, everyone loves these eyeliners. I honestly only use, like, pencil eyeliners for tight lining, and when I used this, some part of the pencil touched my contact lens, and got product on my contact lens, and normally if like I get eye makeup or something in my eye and it gets on my contact, I just like blink a couple times and it kind of will eventually like gunk up and move off to the sides and I can get it out with a Q-tip. This stayed on my contact lens. It was like so permanent, it would not budge. So I had to like take out my contact, scrub it in my hand with some saline to finally get it off. It was ludicrous. It's a really amazing product if you want eyeliner that's not gonna budge, but for my purposes of just tight lining, way too much, freaky, and it was fucking $25. So I returned that. So those were my returns. Not a ton of stuff, but it was a kind of gesture of fuck you to Sephora to return some. So it did. Last haul ever. So, at the beginning of the kind of Beauty Insider points multiplier week, they kicked off that week with a VIB Rouge event. Now, I have been a VIB Rouge for a while, and I have never attended a VIB Rouge event. So I was like, awesome, I'm gonna go to this event, sounds great. And you know what, it was great. Basically, it was VIB Rouge only shopping. And it was the beginning of that four times the points rewards week. So you know, everything you bought, you could kind of say, like, rack up the points for your epic reward that you were hoping to get. They had some croissants and coffee. It was really nice. I had a good time. And the other thing that you got was a special sample bag. And then also during that rewards week, if you order anything online, not only did you get the 4x the points, but you got another special rewards bag of samples. So needless to say, I got both. Really cute, you know, cute kind of like not super high quality canvas. This is the one that I got in store. We got a Benefit Poreffessional. I think you can get this for a 100 point reward at Sephora. Got a Chloe Eau de Parfum. I'm excited about this. It's a fresh rose face mask sample. A L'Occitane en Provence Crème Men hand cream. A lot of stuff. A lot of stuff. A Corez Wild Rose Advanced Brightening Sleeping Facial. It looks like a little facial mask that you put on when you sleep. And then a couple more. Bare Minerals Marvelous Moxie Lip Gloss in the shade Maverick. It's like a sparkly, warm, nude lip gloss. And a Bosha Detoxifying Black Cleanser. Kind of a nice sample size for that little facial cleanser. And then finally, in this first sample bag, a mini Formula X Sheer Strength nail polish in the shade Wondrous. That's sample bag number one. Let's see what's in sample bag number two. Now, this is what you get when you order it online. Another Benefit Poreffessional cute. Another Chloe perfume, awesome. An Elizabeth and James Nirvana. Mary Kay Nashley Olsen's little perfume. Another L'Occitane en Provence hand cream. A Glam Glow Youth Cleanse, little facial cleanser from Glam Glow. Nice size also. A Sephora Rouge Infusion The Neutrals in the shade Peony. It's called Lip Ink. I've actually heard some really great stuff about these. They have this kind of novel but kind of impractical, like, test tube shaped packaging. Pink color lip gloss. Really interesting. Kind of neat. And a Makeup Forever Smoky Extravagant Mascara sample. This is a nice size sample also. Really ginormous, like, Christmas tree shaped brush. Interesting. And then finally, a Kat Von D tattoo eyeliner in the shade Trooper. Now, I was really excited to get this in the mail because I was, like, anticipating winning the whole vault thing, but now it's just kind of like a rude reminder of the fact that Kat Von D, one of my favorite makeup brands, is exclusively sold at Sephora. Kat, please start selling your shit on your own website. Please, 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 we want it. We want it. That's sample bag number two. Yay! Alright, cool. So now let me talk about the four full-size products that I purchased. Okay, first off, I got this Becca Ever Matte Poreless Priming Perfector. This is the kind of little mini size that you can kind of get on the way out, like a little travel size. It is a mattifying primer. It is really intense. It is, like, very thick. Not super silicone-y, but it's thick, and you kind of just have to dab it on and not rub it around too much, or else it'll get pilly and kind of bunch up and make your application of your makeup very difficult. I've used this a couple times, don't know how I feel about it. We'll see. Interesting. Expensive? Does it work? I don't know. Another product from Becca, I got this blush in the shade Songbird. Becca came out with some newer blushes recently. This is not one of them, this is actually one of the older blushes. But it is this really beautiful kind of like goldeny peach. Just like a really true deep peach. You know, like medium to deep peach blush. I was swatching stuff in the store, and this, I think, is a dupe for that peachy Too Faced blush. The Peachy Love Flush blush. I think it's in the shade I Will Always Love You. It's like a kind of sparkly peach blush. I don't have it, but it's a dupe for that. I wore this out. I'll insert a little picture of it. Really love it. Really nice. Okay, I got one more blush. This is the Clinique Cheek Pop in the shade Pansy Pop. I haven't owned any of these blushes, so I was really interested in trying this. Really cute kind of like acrylic case, clear acrylic case with a little embossed flower on it. And it's just like a really beautiful, like, lavender, like kind of cool lavender shade that looks really well with corals. So I'm wearing that actually today in combination with some other cheek products. I think it works really well, like, to complement all this crazy other coral shit that I got going on. Yay! This formula is a little thinner than like a NARS blush or the Too Faced blushes, just not as pigmented. I would have preferred it to be a little thicker, but I'm just in love with this shade, so I unfortunately will not be returning this. So I can't stick this to the man. I'm gonna keep it. Stick it to my lady face. Finally, I got this Makeup Forever Star Powder. Now, this is in the shade 947. I think it's called Iridescent Peach or Light Peach. The Makeup Forever Star Powder is this like really beautiful, very fine, like shimmery powder. And I actually was swatching a bunch of highlighters when I went and bought my Becca Moonstone highlighter in the store, and one of the Sephora cast members said, you should try Star Powder. It's a really beautiful and unique highlight. It's kind of like duochrome-y, iridescent, and it really is beautiful. It's a very interesting kind of like special kind of highlight. It's not like your everyday just kind of like glowing, awesome, perfect, whatever. You know, it's a little dramatic, but that's my middle name, baby. Anyway, so okay, shoot, I forgot I got two other products. I got two more liquid lipsticks. I know I said in my last video that I probably wasn't gonna buy any more, but I had to. This is in the shade Ayesha, and this is in the shade Mother. Now, Mother is the best formula of these liquid lipsticks that I have tried, hands down. Ayesha, second best. Really fabulous, awesome. Ayesha is a kind of like dusty lavender shade, and Mother is a kind of like warm nude medium pink, I guess. Really beautiful, happy to add them to my KVD liquid lipsticks collection, but again, am sad that right as of yet, the only place you can buy Kat Von D lipsticks is at Sephora. Okay, so that is my haul. That is my Sephora haul. My last Sephora haul ever. I kind of blew through it because I think there's some more important things that we have to talk about. What is the silver fucking lining of all of this? For me, and I think a lot of other former Sephora patrons, the Beauty Insider program is kind of meaningless. I totally don't value it anymore. Like, what is the reason for me to save my points? Like, I'm not gonna be able to redeem them in one fell swoop and get something awesome. Ugh. Now I just have to, like, wait for the remotely good rewards for me to spend my 2,000 points on. Luckily, one that just recently came out is worth it. This is a 250 point Bite Beauty reward. It is a limited edition, comes in this little box, comes with these two lip products. They're both in the same shade, Bellini, a little pink lipstick. It's really cute. Just a really like kind of beautiful, like creamy, luminous cream lipstick. And then this is the matching gloss. Now I've never used a Bite gloss, and these are really, really nice. It's like very bright, very creamy, a little bit sticky, which is okay, just really beautiful. And here they are. Now they do, this shade does stain. Okay, and then this really cute little, I thought it was a button, but it is actually a compact, little compact mirror. Oh look, where's all my stuff? Yay. So for 250 points, limited edition shades from Bite Beauty, which is a fabulous company, which you can get elsewhere, like at the Bite Beauty store in New York City. Really awesome. Go spend your points on that because it's a good one. I want to get rid of these points. I want to purge them. I want to sever the ties, cut the cords. Just do it. Go. Go. There's one other silver lining, and it's that in my purchasing, I purchased this product that totally doesn't work for me shade-wise. Now, I didn't even swatch it or anything. I just know that it doesn't work for me. I didn't even open it. It's brand new. So, I'm going to be doing a giveaway with it. I'm not going to tell you what it is or more about it because I don't want to spoil it. But I just want to say that, like, from the sadness of this Sephora Epic Rewards fail, there will be a giveaway. And I'm going to do that giveaway when I reach 500 subscribers. So tell your friends! Okay, so the takeaway is... Hey guys, sorry I had to fast forward through that outro really quick. Basically, I just said a bunch of stuff about consumerism and your money being a source of power and capitalism and spend your money and change the world and stuff like that. Okay, this is a little update to that whole video. Right now it's like 4 a.m. I just got home from a party. My voice is a little raspy just because I was performing at Bushwig this weekend and I kind of blew out my voice a little bit. I'm gonna post a video of that performance on my channel. But basically I just wanted to give you an update because some important things have happened since I first filmed this video, and I wanted to include this little update as part of this entire video because I think it's really relevant. So Sephora finally did do something to kind of appease the masses. Everyone was kind of waiting to see what they would do, and they requested that if you had been wronged by the whole VIB Epic Rewards fail thing, that you write a special email address and they'll, you know, respond to your claim or whatever. Now everyone was assuming that they would just give us all like 1,000 points or whatever, which is, you know, meaningless now, frankly. But that's not what happened. Sephora gave everyone that wrote in and complained a $50 gift certificate to Sephora, which is pretty awesome and huge. I mean, that's like good PR. That's like taking a bad situation that they created, taking responsibility for it, and owning up to it and changing it. So, am I happy that I got a $50 gift certificate? Yeah. Did Sephora deal with that the right way? Yeah. Yeah, they did. I'm gonna give it to them. I'm gonna say that yes, they have mended this wrong. In fact, I used that $50 gift. That $50 gift certificate was available to everyone that wrote in before a certain time, and it is valid until September 30th. Now, I was kind of waiting to see when the Kat Von D Mi Vida Loca remix palette was going to be released, and it came out today, and I bought it with my $50 gift certificate. So I ended up paying $9 for the Mi Vida Loca remix palette, which I'm so excited about getting. Like I said, Kat Von D is one of my favorite makeup brands, and it's a bummer that they're exclusively sold at Sephora, but it was kind of cool that I got to use this gift certificate to kind of get that product that I really wanted. Anyway, so yay, good on Sephora, good job with the $50. That's really huge, actually. It's like a huge, awesome hooray. Okay, but here's the thing, that the whole system of the points and everything, it's still there. It's still flawed. Like, the thousands of points that you have, you're not going to be able to redeem them. There has been no indication that Sephora is interested in or capable of having an epic rewards or extraordinary rewards situation where everyone can be satisfied. Now, I'm assuming that they're not going to want to give out thousands, hundreds, whatever, however many $50 gift certificates they did when they fuck up next time, so I'm gonna guess they're maybe gonna try to make it better for next time. I don't know. I don't know how they're gonna do that or what they're gonna do. All I know is that even though this gesture was amazing and really great, it's still not enough for me to exclusively shop at Sephora or to even give my business to Sephora when I could give it to another company. For example, if I'm interested in an Urban Decay product, like there are some eyelashes that I think are really cool. I was obsessed with the Cabaret lashes from Sephora, which were these kind of like angled, amazing things. I would wear them as bottom lashes, and I just ran out of my last pair. Napoleon Purtis has a lash that is very similar to that also, which I have to try to get somehow. I know they were just on sale at Nordstrom and I missed it. Anyway, blah, 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 blah. But there are some Urban Decay lashes that I'm kind of interested in getting. Now, if I do buy them, I'm going to buy them on the Ulta website. I'm going to get them via Ulta because, like I said, that point system is so much more user-friendly. It's more beneficial to the buyer. You get much more with those points. Yeah, I'm really only gonna shop at Sephora for things that are exclusive to Sephora, or if there's an incentive that is more than just racking up these still utterly meaningless VIB points. Now, like I said earlier, that the 250 Bite Beauty reward, that particular shade that I talked about, Bellini, it is currently unavailable, but now there's a new shade, Mimosa, which I put in my cart also when I picked up the Kat Von D Mi Vida Loca Remix palette. So there is still an amazing 250 point Bite Beauty reward. So that's a little update on that reward. But hopefully they'll continue to like release these awesome higher point value perks, just so that we can like purge these points that we have, but not feel the need to accumulate more points for a high ticket item, like a big trip or something that, you know, we know we'll never get now. So that's kind of the update. So I guess now the takeaway is this was just like a wake-up call for us makeup consumers. Like, we do have influence on what happens, which is really amazing to know that, like, the amount of complaining and whining or whatever it was that we did got Sephora's attention, and they decided to appease us with this gift certificate thing. So that was really great. I mean, it's great that Sephora did that, but it's also just great to know that your kind of voice is heard, and it actually just instills more power in this very medium, this YouTube, social media, self-propagating, consumer-driven review format, which I'm really excited to be a part of. And if anything, it's gotten me, you know, more excited about the potential of my influence as a consumer and a consumer reviewer. So I'm feeling positive about the whole thing now, less miffed about it. The 50 bucks definitely helped, but I'm also excited to, you know, find other places to spend my money that will provide for their customers a little better, that do provide for their customers a little better. And, you know, and it's good to know that none of these companies are kind of immune to the power of the verdicts of the court of public opinion. So anyway, I'm Kimberly Clark, and that was my last Sephora haul ever. I will probably not be doing one for a while. I will talk about the Mi Vida Loca Remix palette as soon as I get it, which is in a couple days. I'm really excited. Thanks so much for watching, and I hope that if you had this kind of negative experience with Sephora that I did and that many people did, I hope that the gift certificate, if you got it, was something that helped you kind of get over it a little bit. And also, I guess the positive takeaway of really seeing how much you as a consumer can influence change in company policy and stuff, that's like a really cool thing. Just think about that. That's a good way to think about it. Cool? Alright. Please subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. Like this video and check out some of my other videos. And have a great day. Bye. Oh my god. Bye. Bye, Sephora. Get out of my hair.